Teratomas are germ cell tumours. They arise from cells that are pluripotent, or an alternative term is totipotent. This means simply that they can differentiate into a number of different tissue types. So, teratomas contain cells representing one or usually two or three germ cell layers. The three embryological germ cell layers are ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. To briefly give examples of the different cell layers, skin arises from ectoderm, gut epithelium arises from endoderm, and striated muscle, cartilage and fat arise from mesoderm. Teratomas may be benign or malignant. This is the typical gross appearance of a testicular teratoma. Teratomas arise from germ cells, usually in the testis or ovary, but they may arise from germ cells elsewhere. These are typically in the midline in sites including mediastinum, the sacrococcygeal region in children, and the pineal gland. This tumour is an example of a mediastinal teratoma. This is another example of a teratoma that has arisen in a site other than the gonads, and this has arisen in the sacrococcygeal region in a child. One of the tissue types represented here that we are zooming into is cartilage. In this case, it is rather immature. The germ cell layer represented here is, of course, mesoderm. As mentioned earlier, teratomas may be benign or malignant. Those arising in the ovary are usually benign, and these are known as dermoid cysts. Dermoid cysts typically contain hair, and they may also sometimes contain teeth. In contrast, teratomas arising in the testis are invariably malignant. This is the gross appearance of a dermoid cyst in the ovary. This is part of another dermoid cyst. You can see hair arising from the lining of the cyst and also a rather well-formed tooth.